Welcome to this week's news episode. On this week's news episode, we're going to be looking back into the Nissan Leaf Gate. We're also going to be looking at news regarding Tesla and Nvidia, and also something to do with Jaguar and Waymo. So let's jump straight into it. Nissan Leaf Gate. I did a video about it last week. Thanks very much if you have watched it. It has been my most popular video yet. I've been blown away by the response, views, comments, likes. Thank you very much. Also, welcome to all my new subscribers from that video. It's been great. It's great to know that you enjoyed my videos. If you haven't, by the way, already, please click subscribe down the bottom. It helps my channel grow. The Nissan response for Leafgate was, at the start, very poor. There was no response. They finally responded, which... A little bit of a round of applause there, Nissan. Thank you, well done. They've actually admitted that there is a problem, so that is a good start. However, they've said it's isolated. It's an isolated problem to a couple of users. However, it seems to be more than a couple. It seems to be, you know, a lot more than a couple, considering it is a new vehicle. The 2018 Nissan Leaf came out in 2018, and there's been quite a few reports of YouTube users and also from general driving users who've experienced this problem. Yes, I will agree that the chance of you rapid charging 2-3 times on a journey is very, very, very remote. However, on the second rapid charge, your charge slows down. By the third, it is extremely slow. The point is that Nissan have admitted it, so that's a good start. They're saying they're working with users that have reported it to help resolve the issue. So the first thing I'll say is, if you've got a 2018 Nissan Leaf and you've experienced this issue, ring Nissan, report it, and feedback information to me in the comments. Let me know, are they working with you? Are they helping you resolve this issue? Are they looking into it? What have they done? Have they brought you into the Nissan garage to upload from your OBD systems? Or are they just lying to us all over? They're just fobbing you off. It'd be great to know. Leave a comment in the section below. But the important thing is they have acknowledged it and they are trying to work for a solution. This week, the Tesla and Nvidia shares have took a bit of a plummet on the stock market. And this is down to something that happened the week before, which wasn't involving either... Well, it was involving Nvidia, but it wasn't involving Tesla. And that was the Uber car crash, self-driving car crash. If you haven't heard about this already, an Uber car... sadly killed a lady sadly lost her life when crossing the road. She approached from between two hedges, two bushes. The safety driver was on his phone and wasn't paying attention, and the lady sadly got killed and run over. The problem is the LiDAR didn't pick her up, but then the safety driver wasn't paying attention, so he didn't brake. Now, judging by the footage that I've seen and also the police reports, it says that pretty much she would have been hit even if the car was being driven by a normal person. The question is, would an old person have been able to slow their car down enough to prevent the fatality from prevent her being killed? And we'll never know. Sadly, we'll never know. But we should have the computer data on why the LiDAR failed, and hopefully Uber and all the other self-driving car companies who have safety drivers will re-vet the safety drivers they're employing, who sat in the cars, to make sure they are, you know, competent and safe to watch the road at all time and won't be on their phone not paying attention. Now, the reason Nvidia shares have been hit by this is Nvidia are a chip maker. They make computer chips, and they make most of the chips that go into autonomous cars, if pretty much not all of them. And that is the reason why it's affected. A lot of people are worried that because of the crash that self-driving cars are not all they're cracked up to be and they're never going to hit market. But we need to remember that self-driving cars are in very, very, very early development. I mean, extremely early development. We're probably not going to see fully autonomous cars on the road for a very, very long time. They're still being tested. They still have to have safety drivers. They have God knows how many computers. The data is... They are in very early testing phases, and we need to remember that before we sort of hit them with sort of harsh penalties. If anything, the safety driver should be the only person hit with a penalty, because at the end of the day, he's supposed to have full control of the car if anything happens on the LiDAR or computer system. I mean, at the end of the day, the computer system could have crashed, and that's why the car didn't stop, in which case the safety driver should have been there to take over. The reason why Tesla have shares dropped is also because they invest heavily in autonomous cars. There's a couple of other things hitting Tesla at the moment. One is obviously they've dropped shares because there's a few complaints about Model 3 panel alignment issues and stuff like that. We need to remember that Tesla is like Apple of the car industry. They create fantastic technology, interesting products. They are not really a car company. They are very new to the car spectrum. Think of them more as a technology company. We need to support Tesla. And if I was you, Tesla have at the lowest share point they've been in 12 months. If I'm, as an investor, as a person who buys shares, I will be buying more Tesla shares. And the reason, I'm driving my dog mad, by the way. My dog's called Tess. I named her after Tesla. And every time I say Tess, she keeps looking up like, why are you saying my name? But the reason why Tesla shares are at the lowest point and you should buy them. And the reason for that is Tesla do one thing, and that is they always prove everyone wrong. Every time someone says their shares are failing, they double in price by the next year. So at the lowest point they've ever been in 12 months, I'd buy some. They're a good investment to hold on to. Even if you're looking at a 6-month investment, 12-month investment, they're a good investment to buy, especially with a lot of companies now already signing up to the Tesla mega truck system that's coming out. A lot of big firms are already interested in making large bulk orders for that, so that will just keep pushing Tesla shares up and up and up when they eventually get to product rolling. Jaguar and Waymo are working together in partnership. They are in the first 2 years going to put 20,000 vehicles on the road. Waymo, by the way, if you didn't know, used to be Google cars, Google self-driving cars. So makes you wonder if anyone's actually really worried about self-driving cars after the Uber incident, because Jaguar and Waymo are going to really, really be pushed. 20,000 units in 2 years production is a lot of self-driving cars to be put on the road and tested. Test start this year on the Ipace for Waymo, and that's going to be great. It's going to be great to see that Jaguar and Land Rover are looking really pushing towards this sort of electric self-driving autonomous future. Thanks very much for watching this week's video. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you again next week. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye.